Dear children, today we are going to focus on the topic the noun number. Before starting this chapter, let us revise what is a noun. If you remember, all the naming words are called nouns. It is the name of a person, place, animal or thing, or it is the name of an object, feelings, ideas or emotions. Now, nouns can be of two types, can be either singular or plural in number. Let's see what is singular noun and what is plural noun. A noun which stands for one person, animal or thing is said to be in the singular number. When we talk about only one person, only one object or only one animal, means we use singular noun. For example, boy. Here it means we are talking only about one boy. So this is singular in number. Let's see other examples. Book. Girl, watch, hero, wolf. All these are the nouns in singular form because they refer to only one person or only one thing or only one animal. Now let's see what is plural noun. A noun which stands for more than one person, animal or thing is said to be in plural number. For example, boys, books, girls, watches, heroes, wolves. In all these examples, we can see that these words refer to more than one person, animal or thing. Now, very important thing. Formation of plurals. Dear children, from singular nouns only we make the plural forms. And for changing them into plural, we have to follow certain rules. Let us study all these rules. First one is by changing F or FE into VES. Dear children, if your word ends in F or FE, the last letter or letters of the word are F or FE, are changed into VES. Let's see the examples. Calf, C-A-L-F. The last letter is F. So, it will be changed into VES. F will be changed into VES to get the plural form. C-A-L-V-E-S, calves. Wife, W-I-F-E. The last two word, the letters are F-E. F-E will be changed into V-E-S. W-I-V-E-S, wives, is the plural form of the noun wife. Dear children, when we change them into plural form, as we change F for FE into VES, the sound also change. Instead F sound, we use V sound. Wife, wives. In wife, we can hear the sound of F, but in wives, we can hear the sound of V. Now, let's see the next rule. By adding ES to the singular when noun ends in S, SS, CH, SH or X. When the singular noun is ending with all these letters, what we do? We add ES with the word. For example, gas, G-A-S, the last letter is S. So, we add E-S with it to get the plural form. We get the plural form, gases. as, a double s. Last two letters are double s. So we add es with it to make the plural form. We get asses. Badge. Badge is ending with ch. So we add es with it to get the plural form. Batches. Then bush, ending with sh. So we add es with it to get the plural form. Bushes. And the last example, box, box, ending with x. So we add es with it to get the plural form, boxes. The rule number 3 is, by adding s to the singular, when a noun ending in y has a vowel before it. Dear children, if your word is ending in y, the last letter is y, and before y any vowel comes. Vowels means a, e, I, o, u. These 5 letters are called vowels. And before y, if any vowel comes, in that case we just add s with the word to make the plural form. For example, key. Here you can see the last letter is y, and before y comes the vowel e. So we just add s with it to get the plural form. Keys. K-E-Y-S. Keys. Boy. B-O-Y. Boy. Last letter is y, but before y comes a vowel o. In that case we just add s with it. B-O-Y-S. Boys is the plural form. Next is essay. E-S-S-A-Y. Here we can see last letter is y, and before y a vowel comes, that is a. So in that case we just add s with it. E-S-S-A-Y-S. Essays. Now the next rule is, by changing y into I and adding es to the singular, when a noun ending in y has a consonant before it. In the previous rule you studied that if word is ending in y and before y any vowel comes, in that case you just add s. But in this rule you can see that if word is ending in y but before y any consonant comes, you have to change y into I and add es with it. Let's try to understand through the example. Army. A-R-M-Y. Army. The last letter is y, and before y we can see the consonant m comes. So y will be changed into I and will add es with it. A-R-M-I-E-S. Armies. Baby. B-A-B-Y. Baby. The last letter is y, and before y the consonant b comes. So in that case again we'll change y into I, adding es with it. B-A-B-I-E-S. Babies. Next example you can see here, library. L-I-B-R-A-R-Y. Here word is ending with y, and before y comes the consonant r. So y will be changed into I plus es. L-I-B-R-A-R-I-E-S. Libraries. Now the next rule is, by adding es to the nouns ending in o. By adding es to the noun ending in o. Dear children, when word is ending in o, we have to add es with it to make the plural form. Buffalo. We add es with it, buffaloes. Hero plus es, heroes. Mango plus es, mangoes. But there is exceptions. Dear children, in some of the words This rule is not applicable. Though these words are ending with O, but still we do not add ES with them, but we just add S with them to make the plural form. For example, photo, P-H-O-T-O, photo, plus S becomes photos, the plural form. Here we have added only S with it to make the plural. Piano, pianos, radio, radios. In all these examples, you can see, though the words are ending in O, but still we have used S with it. Dear children, these kinds of words we need to memorize. Now, the next rule is by changing the internal vowels. In some of the words, we do not add S or ES with them to change into plural form. But what we do? We change the internal vowels. Let's see the example. Foot. F-O-O-T. Foot. What are the internal vowels? Double O. Double O will be changed into double E to get the plural form. Feet. G-O-O-S-E. Goose will become geese. Woman will become women. W-O-M-E-N. Women. Next rule is by adding en or ren. For changing from singular to plural, we add en or ren with some of the words. For example, child. Child is singular form. We add ren with it to make the plural form. Children. Ox. We add en with it and we get the plural form. Oxen. Now let's talk about the next rule, compound nouns by changing the principal word into plural or by adding S to the first element or the first part. In compound nouns, whatever is the principal word or the main word, we add S with it. For example, commander-in-chief. What is the principal word here? Commander. We add S with it, commanders-in-chief. Brother-in-law, brothers-in-law. Now, the next rule is compound nouns by adding S to the last element. In some of the compound nouns, we add S with the last element, with the last part. For example, stepson. We don't add S here with the first word, but we add S with the second word. Step sons. Grown up, grown ups. Now, the important point to remember is nouns in pair. We use a pair noun for something made of two parts which are the same. Clear? We use a pair noun for something made of two parts which are the same. For example, jeans, pants, trousers, spectacles, scissors. All these are having two parts. You can see the spectacles, one and two, two parts. Two similar parts, the same parts. So, these kind, though this is one spectacle, but we use the plural form to pronounce this. We say spectacles. We never say Caesar, but we say scissors. That is the correct thing. We never say pant. We always say pants, trousers, jeans. Another important point to remember is a pair noun is plural and takes a plural verb. Pair noun is always said in plural form and we use a plural verb with it. For example, where are the scissors? Where are the scissors? Here, scissors is a pair noun. And what is the verb? Are is the verb. We can see are is also plural verb. Clear? We cannot say where is the scissors. It will be wrong. So, dear children, I hope it's clear to you how to change from singular to plural. Thank you.